Welcome to the Pan Players production of The 20th Century.
Attention please, 20th Century Limited for New York and Boston. Now ready on track 14.
Attention please, 20th Century Unlimited to New York and Boston. Now ready on track 14. All aboard!
Mrs. Lockwood, I'm the doctor, she's the wife. We're married, here you go.
Thank you.
Well, that was very smooth, Grover. Now they'll never suspect a thing.
Are you crazy giving out my name like that?
Well, I had to say something, you just stood there.
My wife found out about this.
I know, why don't we talk some more about your wife? Why don't you take out her picture and have a good cry?
You've got a lot of nerve to get Corsican.
I only asked you for your ticket.
Why? But I told you to put that bag in the drawing room, eh, before I flatten you. Mr. Jaffe needs that room.
I already told you there's someone else in drawing room, eh?
Well, you go in there and kick them out because they don't belong there, trust me.
Well, maybe there's some sort of mistake. I'll go check.
Well, I'm going to go with you.
Track 14, all aboard!
Who is it?
Porter!
Just a minute. Okay, come in.
Beg pardon, sir. Can I see your ticket?
Certainly.
What is it, Grover? A darling.
Porter?
A gentleman here says it's his room.
It is not.
Oh, it isn't, is it? Well, then tell me something. Do you lift weights? Do you have any muscles on these bones?
Well, not really.
Well, then why don't we step outside? We can settle this like real men.
Grover, he's drunk. I can smell it from here.
But that's a bloody lie. Not a drop has touched these lips in over 10 minutes.
I'll get the conductor.
Oh, go get the conductor. Go get the whole bloody orchestra. And you. Oh, I'll be back to deal with you in this alleged swirl of ours later.
I'll attend to him. What seems to be the trouble, young man?
Young man? You call me a young man? Ooh, I'll have to give you a kiss.
Get away from me! Now listen here.
No, no, you listen, General. There's a pair of foul turtle doves in drawing room A, and I need you to go in and shoo them out before Mr. Jaffe gets here.
Oh, Mr. Jaffe? You mean Oscar Jaffe, the theatrical man?
The earth shaker himself. I'm his press agent. That can mean me see some action.
May I see your ticket?
How many times must I go over this? I ain't got a bloody ticket.
Well, then I'm sorry you're out of luck here, Mr. Jaffe, or no, Mr. Jaffe.
If you keep this up, I'll eat those buttons off your coat.
Oh, wait. Is everything all fixed?
No, diplomacy ain't working. This here is Miss Ida Webber. It's Jaffe's personal manager. Fix her up, Ida. Fix her up!
Now listen, you.
Oh, and what's the problem?
So Oscar wants Rome, right? But there's two people in there already, and she won't throw him out.
Why Rome?
I have absolutely no idea, but he said it's a matter of life and death.
I see. All right, conductor, I'm going to make a telegram. To Mr. A.L. Johnson, Vice President, New York Central Line. My dear Albert, I'm having some difficulty getting proper service on the Century in charge of conductor. What's your name?
Now listen, Miss Webb.
Speak up, woman.
There's no use wiring anybody here. I'm perfectly willing to give Mr. Jaffe every consideration. I have carried him before, but you're going to have to make arrangements with the people in A.
Happy to, conductor. Who's in A?
Doctor and Mrs.
Oh, it's a doctor and Mrs. Hare! It's Romeo and Juliet, I tell you, without a blood test.
Come on, Owen. Come along, porter.
Oh, what is it now?
Open the door!
Oh, my God.
Right, don't get rattled. Give us away.
What's the meaning of this continual intrusion?
Are you Dr. Lockwood?
Yes, and you are?
Are you Mrs. Lockwood?
Conductor, I'm beginning to feel persecuted.
I'll be right back.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Where are you going?
Oh, I'm going to place a call to the real Mrs. Lockwood and have a little chat with her poor little thing.
No, wait a minute, please.
On the other hand, we don't like conflict. Do we, Owen?
Ooh, not me. I absolutely hate conflict.
Look, Doctor, I've got two tickets here. An upper and a lower berth, two doors down. The difference in price is $15 in your favor. We'll call it $20.
What?
I strongly advise that you take it, and there will be no more questions.
How can you stand for this, Grover?
It'll be all right, honey. Come on.
But Grover?
Don't argue with me. Come on. Porter, bring the bags.
Yes, sir.
Bye, you, honey. All right. We've got the room. Now all we need is Oscar.
I would like to know what he would ever do without us.
Bye. I am glad you fixed the train and all, but why don't you fix one of his plays?
Yes.
Oh, you're such a big turkey. I didn't know whether I should watch it or stuff it and serve it with cranberries.
You know, there's three flops in a row.
Oh,
we haven't had a hit since Lily left him. I told him Joan of Arc wouldn't last a week. Nobody wants to see a dame in an iron petticoat. Hey, you said you weren't going to drink on this train.
Oh, I conquered me willpower.
You again? Excuse me. Listen, the porter said, is it true that you're traveling with Oscar McJaffe, the big producer?
Yeah, that's right.
Well, I've written a play.
Oh, I bet.
Look, would you do me a favor? Would you see that he gets it when he gets here? I mean, I'd really appreciate it.
I don't think Mr. Jaffe would be interested in a play right now.
Oh, he'll be interested in this one, all right. It's unique. It's about Joan of Arc. Look, listen, listen, you owe me a favor, right? So how about this? How about I come back later when Mrs. Abbey's here and we'll show it to him then we'll let him decide.
Fine, come back later.
All righty then. Thanks, fellow thespians.
Repent, for the time is at hand.
To send all the gardenias he has to this room, and I want a card with a message. Let me think a second. To the little lady of the snows. No, I used that last one. One moment. From the grave of someone you loved yesterday. How's that?
Ooh, it's nice and cheerful, Oscar.
It's perfect. Now, why can't I get a couple of playwrights to write for me like that?
You did. That's why we're out of money.
Owen, go order lunch for me. I'm famished.
But Oscar, the diner's packed.
Tell them it's for me, and make sure that they put me by myself at a very large table.
What's your mind? You know, if you want privacy, tell me, why don't you travel in a balloon?
What has O'Malley drinking again? Is it a woman?
Well, yeah, it's a woman. Joan of Arc.
You know what I was thinking, Ida, on my way to the train? I was thinking, that of all my 68 productions, the most beautiful was Joan of Arc. I cried like a baby at every performance.
So did I, but for a different reason.
That fire effect I had at the end, pure genius.
So was the disappearing trick when you made the audience vanish.
Well, I liked it.
Well, I'm glad, because we lost $74,000 on it.
Oh, what a magnificent failure. If I am a genius, Ida, it is because of my failures. Always remember that.
You know, I'm going to put that on a sign and you can wear it on a street corner holding a little cup. I'm a genius. Please feed me. Listen, Oscar, this trip from Chicago to New York takes 16 hours. We arrive in New York at 9 a.m. Banks open at 10.
Oh, don't bother me about money now. Do you mind?
Oscar, if we don't find some cash by tomorrow, they're going to take the Jaffe Theater, and I'm not kidding.
They wouldn't dare.
They issued a writ on Friday.
And who do you think is behind it, I'll tell you who. Max Jacobs, that so-called producer, that cheap little crook that I plucked out of the gutter. I gave him life and he betrayed me. Remember what he said when I fired him? He said he'd have his revenge.
Oscar, it's not Max Jacobs. It's the banks. All the banks. They all got together on Friday.
Oh, they did. Did they? Well, let me tell you something, Ida. Skies were never bluer. Who do you suppose is getting on the train in Englewood, Oh, I'll give you a little hint. She's an old friend of ours. She's got bright silver hair and sparkling eyes. She stands 5'6" with a splendid figure. And if she ever fell into a swamp and ran across a starving crocodile, she'd strangle him, turn him inside out, and make him into a purse with matching shoes.
Lily Garland?
Right.
She's coming back to
you
us?
You bet she is starring in my next production, Back in the Fold, Where She Belongs.
That's the best news I've heard all year.
I knew you'd like it.
When you split up with Lily, I never opened my yap, but I knew you were slitting your own throat.
Oh, you thought I was through, huh? Well, let me tell you something. That is when I am at my best, my girl, with my back against the wall, disaster staring me in the face. Henry VIII. The Bride of Baghdad, Chaim Pippick, they had me down, but I am like a prize fighter, up at the count of nine. Can he get to his feet? He staggers, can he right himself? And then swings with the power of a wounded lion.
I'll tell you one thing, when those bankers see her name on a contract, they can write off her own ticket. She's the biggest draw in the country.
And now we have the compartment right next to hers. Why I needed drawing room A.
Oh, so that was it.
Now, here's my plan. You will run into her accidentally and let her know that I have in hand the most extraordinary new play with a part that fits her like a glove. Half woman, half devil, maybe the greatest character ever put on stage.
Wow, what's the play?
I have no idea. I'm going to have to find someone who can write it for me. But remind me to find out if Bertolt Brecht is available. Ooh, or that new chap, Noel Coward. We could add music.
Oscar.
Oh, Ibsen. Ibsen. Find out if Ibsen is still alive.
Have you got Lily under contract or not?
Oh, don't get technical with me, Ida.
It's the contract that will make all the difference.
Well, don't worry about it. She'll sign for me. I created her.
Was she glad to see you, Elise?
See me when? I haven't seen her for years.
Oh,
don't worry about it, Ida. She'll sign for me. Remember, I never closed the iron door on her.
Oscar, listen to me. Will you just listen? The banks will not stop foreclosing on your theater until they see Lily's name on a contract, black and white, signed.
I understand that, which is why you will bump into Lily accidentally and let her know that I'm on the train. She'll be ecstatic, but she'll try to hide it. And mention that the part in question has been promised to Loretta Young. She hates her. It was Loretta she caught me in bed with.
Loretta Young.
I told her that Shirley Temple was our love child.
Quite snooty into the hit she's made.
What hit?
The movies.
Oh, she'll never be any good in the movies.
Talking about, she won the gold statue.
What gold statue?
The gold statue that some academy gives every year for the best performance. They're calling her the new Marlena Dietrich.
But that's impossible. She'll never be any good in the movies. She's got a face like a soft-shell crab. It took me 4 years to make her look even vaguely human.
Listen, Oscar, as long as this Lily Garland thing isn't indefinite, I've got something to suggest. I got a telegram this morning from Max Jacobs.
Looking for a job, I suppose.
Why it means his own accord.
You know, I refuse for you to ever mention the name Max Jacobs to me again, and that's final. Besides, his real name is Mandelbaum. Max Mandelbaum. He started out selling herring on 34th Street until they arrested him for unclean practices. I fired him for stealing.
You fired him for Carmen.
Who's Carmen?
The opera Carmen. The one you produced together. You insisted upon putting a live bull on the stage.
He was a magnificent animal.
He fell to the orchestra pit. He had to be shot in front of the audience.
Yeah, that was tragic.
You had him ground into hamburger.
I was merely trying to salvage our investment.
That's not the point. The point is, Max disagreed with you.
The point is, what does Max Jacobs know about the theater?
Knows enough to have produced 3 hits in a row while you have had one egg after the other.
I have had enough of your treachery. Get out of my sight. No, you have shown your true colors. Now get out. You are fired. You are like Brutus in the marketplace, stabbing the only man who's ever been any good to you. Go to Mandelbaum. Sell herring together. Out! Out! Out, you traitor! I close the iron door on you!
It was awful. I hardly knew what was happening. I was just sitting reading the magazine when all of a sudden I felt something hit me on the top of the head.
Did you see anyone go by?
No, but when I took off my hat, this sticker was on it. Repent, for the time is at hand.
That's the one. There's hundreds of them all over the train.
I'm sure who's ever doing it doesn't mean any harm.
Well, maybe. But it could be a crackpot with a gun.
Oh, dear. That's awful. I just don't understand it, conductor. First it was the drawing room, and now this. Oh,
well, I can assure you, madame, that it's just a coincidence. Unless Mr. Jaffe and his crew have something to do with it, and I wouldn't put it past them.
Doctor, look, I bet she did it.
That wouldn't surprise me in the least. All right, my good woman, this time you've gone too far.
Beg your pardon?
Oh, you don't know what I'm talking about, hey? What's that on the back of your hat? Give me that!
Oh, repent for the time is at hand. What was this? I don't understand. You're crazy? You ready as a fruitcake? I got a promise.
You're going to take a bucket of water and some hot water and soap and wash every one of these stickers off the tray.
Conductor, conductor, somebody just went through the dining car this minute and stuck him out all the window.
Did you see him?
No, just the back of him. But he's heading towards the caboose.
All right, come on. You won't get away with it this time. Miss, I guess you're not guilty this time.
He closed the iron door.
Hey, boss! Where's Ida?
Miss?
Miss Webb is no longer with us. We are but two musketeers now, so we shall have to fight on all the harder, like Damon and Pythias, like Robin Hood and Little John, like Sherlock Holmes and a slightly drunken Dr. Watson. Sit down, Owen, take out your pencil. I need you to send a wire to all of the dramatic critics in New York and tell them that I closed Joan of Arc as a gesture.
As a gesture of what?
Of defiance. The play was unworthy of me.
Oh, that shows what I know. I always thought it was because the play stank.
You have no soul, Owen. There were beautiful moments in that play.
I'm sure you're right, Oscar. Did see the disadvantage, though. My seat, Oscar. Just facing the stage.
I'm Mr. Jaffe.
Yes?
How do you do, sir? I'm Dr. Lockwood.
Owen, did you call for a doctor?
Oh, no, sir. I'm here in a private capacity. I've written a play, sir, especially for you. It's called Joan of Arc. Now, you see, by day I may be a doctor, but at night, alone in my room, using nothing but a simple pen, I explore my inner reaches.
I don't even want to think about that.
Will you read it, sir? You must. It's magnificent. I've taken a whole new approach to the subject. I have given Joan a friend, a strong, dedicated man that she can rely on, the kind of man that every girl dreams of, a doctor.
Give the play to my secretary and I'll read it later.
Oh, now, please. Good care of this. It's the only copy I have in the world.
Oh, memorize it, Doc.
Now, Owen, don't be funny. Play is a sacred trust. It is the earth in which the rest of us grow.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Jaffe.
You're welcome. Now, if you don't mind, I am quite busy. Throw that thing away, Owen, very far away. Owen.
Aye.
Owen, did you happen to read the telegram from Max Jacobs?
Oh, I sure did, Oscar, yeah.
What did it say?
He said he's got a new play and he wants you to direct it for him. And he said he'd give you 10%.
Give him.
Oh, yeah.
Get me! The man is in an opium stupor. He takes drugs. I never told you that. He's a drug addict.
Oh, take a wire, Owen, to Max Jacobs, nay Mandelbaum. I have it on very good authority that you have on your body more diseases than are believed to exist on the Asian continent.
Oscar, this will never get through.
Oh, all right, start again. Dear Max, you are the most vile, foul, putrid piece of trash that has ever walked the earth, and I say that with all due respect. In reply to your impudent offer, I am holding open your old job as office boy, feeling that you will need it when even that part of the public that enjoys filth in the theater has been nauseated beyond endurance by your degenerate offerings.
That's a teacher, not a point.
Englewood, now arriving. Englewood, Illinois.
Owen, she's getting on here. Lily Garland.
Lily's back.
Oh, Owen, I have tried to get her out of my brain for years, but I have failed. She's in here, gnawing at my heart like some gray rat. When I love a woman, Owen, I am an Oriental. It never goes. It never dies. The only way that I can breathe again is to get her back.
And make her pay for what she's done to me!
You know, Oscar, if she doesn't throw her arms around you the minute she sees you, well then, she's just a bigger fool than I ever thought she was.
Irishman. Every once in a blue moon, you say just the right thing. You've stopped.
Englewood!
Let's go out to the platform and watch your demand.
Shh, shh, shh.
We have to be Indians.
Another compartment, another lonely room. No one cares that I'm Lily Garland. All they want of me is more and more. I could be a rag doll or an animal in the circus. What do they care? Oh God, I'm so tired.
Ah, you poor thing.
Why do I do it, George? It's not for the money. I despise money. I despise all those trappings, those baubles, those symbols of emptiness. Where's my luggage?
The porter said it'll be right in.
My jewelry's in there.
Lily, it's fine.
The necklace that Louis Mayer gave me, the tiara.
Lily.
I left you in charge of my luggage, you blockhead. That jewelry's worth a fortune.
I have your jewelry right here. I kept it separate.
Oh, darling, don't ever scare me like that. It's not the money I care about. It's because I grew up poor and frightened, like a little orphan in the rain.
Well, you're doing all right now. I mean, look at this place. It's like a fancy French chapeau. I've got that contract from Paramount for you.
I'm glad you mentioned it, because I want $80,000 for the next picture. $50,000 is ridiculous.
But you've already signed it.
I don't care what I signed. You're not just my lover. You're my agent. Now go fix it. If they say no, the heck with them. Besides, my public wants me on Broadway anyhow.
Broadway? That's peanuts. You're a star. Forget about acting. I know it's good for my little girl.
Oh, George, darling, I'm going to miss you terribly when I'm in New York.
Lily.
One last kiss before you go, my darling. I'll be dreaming of your arms holding me in the night and your little head on the pillow.
Lily, you don't have to dream of staying on the train.
What?
I'm staying.
What are you talking about, George?
I decided to come with you.
You'll do what I tell you. Get off right now.
And leave you in New York with all those men? Not a chance.
George, we're moving. Get off quick.
No.
Jump, do what I tell you.
Look, the doors will be locked. It's too late.
Jump out the window. You seem to forget entirely that I'm paying you 10% of my earnings as this financial agent. Thousands of dollars for doing absolutely nothing. And you take it, you worm.
That's right. Keep it up. I like seeing your true colors.
Oh, darling. You can still get off at the next stop from me, my darling.
Lily, you're cooling off. I can tell.
No, that's not true. I adore you. You're all I have in the world. What else is there? Fame, success, empty words, empty gestures.
Would you stop acting?
I beg your pardon.
I can always tell when you're acting. You repeat things. Empty words, empty gestures, those symbols, those baubles. It sets a kind of rhythm.
How dare you second guess me? How dare you?
See what I mean?
How dare you? How dare you?
Well, hello, you peculiar witch! How's the baby Burns heart?
Oh, son of a gun, the foul Corsican himself! Who let you on this train?
Do you know how much trouble you've caused around this gondola last half hour? Oh, we nearly torn it to shreds, I tell you.
We? Who's we?
Why don't you guess?
Oh, my God! Is Oscar Jaffe on this train?
You see, the little corporal's returning from Moscow. His head is a little bloody, but it is still unbowed.
Jaffe? Oscar Jaffe? I should have known. That's why you wanted me off this train, so you two could cuddle up together.
I had no idea he was on this train, you idiot.
Oh, yeah, you're gonna see him, huh? Tell me the truth.
See him? Do you think I'm out of my mind? My God, you told me. I'm not stepping out of this room till I get to New York, so help me God. That man has belittled and tortured me for 6 years. He ran around telling everyone, oh, where would Lily Garland be without the great Oscar Jaffe? Huh. I showed him right to the top of the ladder, and I'm still going up.
Hey, Lily.
Hi, are you too?
I'm back into the fall.
Ah,
Is she what?
Coming back.
You see, it's two words, and it rhymes with slumming hack.
So does humming sack.
Oh, did Jackie tell you to come in here?
Oh, don't fly off the handle. Confidentially. Not with Jackie anymore. You've come to tip me off about something.
Can we talk in front of Einstein,
though? Listen, get the hell out of here is what you can do.
George, be quiet and behave yourself.
Well, I've come to tell you that they're taking the Jaffe Theater from him, the bank's off. Oscar's broke.
And this?
We've got him over a barrel with his pants down.
Oh, that's quite an image.
He's thinking of doing the Dutch act.
Kill himself?
Oh, point his finger at his head and click his tongue.
Is he doing that again? You know, committing suicide like an old habit of his?
Yeah. Remember when he was going to hang himself and you stayed up all night talking him out?
We all make mistakes.
Lily, if you don't come to his rescue, it's curtains for him. You're his last chance.
May I drop down where I'm standing and do another play with him? Go back and tell that fake Scavalli I wouldn't wipe my feet on him if he was starving. And I hope to God he is.
And she means every word of that. That was a single double repeat of the whole speech.
Shut up, George!
You can't turn your back on him now. He made you.
He what?
You were out in the street begging for a job. He taught you how to walk. He taught you how to talk.
George, get him out of here right now!
Gladly!
Who was it, you?
I thought you were a bigger woman than this!
Get out!
I'm deeply disappointed!
George, why do they do this to me? Who do they think I'm made out of? Iron? Hammering and hammering at me, all of them, tearing at my nerves. All I want is a little peace. Oh my God, I'm having a nervous breakdown. I'm getting hot. Oh, I feel it coming. Oh, my God. And then I won't be good for anything. And you'll all stop. You'll all stop.
Lily, Lily, calm down. Now, I want the simple, honest truth about you and Jaffe. Were you ever lovers?
Lovers?
Did he ever have relations with you?
I know what lovers mean, you idiot. George. On my mother's grave, Oscar Jaffe never laid a finger on me.
I don't believe you.
Why do you aggravate me?
I can't stand it when you're with other men. It makes me nuts.
I don't even know what I see in you. You either bore me to death with your jealousy or drives me crazy.
This means you don't love me at all. All I am to you is a rag doll you can drag around, a piece of paper you can tear up, a flagpole you can sit on.
Oh, darling, forgive me, I adore you.
You tell me the truth about you and Jack.
I told you the truth. I told you about all my lovers. The Chinese acrobat who did everything upside down, he almost killed me. The little Filipino monk with the black hood and the candles. Even the Italian midget with the huge hands. Oh my God, the midget was hard to confess. And now? Now you must think I'm a wanton, a country wench. No, George, don't look down on me, darling. Don't look down on me.
Lily, your honesty is the only thing that saved our love. This is the last time I'll ever ask you, I promise. Did Jaffe ever touch you as a woman?
Never, I swear to God, he never touched me.
Oh, thank God, thank God.
Darling.
The first night I slept with Lily Garland was the greatest night of my life. I remember it like it was yesterday, Owen. Now, what did you say? Tell me everything.
Well, you know her, Oscar. She screamed like a fishwife.
Good sign. Shows the battery's not dead. You didn't make her feel necessary, did you?
Oh, no, Oscar, not so worse.
Excellent. Now, for my next trick, I'm going to sweep her off her feet.
Oh, my darling, my darling.
So beautiful, so handsome.
Did you hear that? Who is that man?
Well, that's your agent, Oscar. I think he's negotiating.
Can you believe it? That baggage, that trauma, mousing around with boys after what she's had? Oh, I always knew she'd end up back in the gutter. Get me Ida right away.
You want her back?
Oscar. Get me Ida this instant. Ida!
I wouldn't have believed it.
What?
The fellow that's been pasting up all them stickers on the train? It's the little lady, Miss Clark, in room D. This here telegram from her nephew says she escaped from an asylum. Some sort of religious nut does this all the time. We'll pick her up in Toledo, accept no checks. She's the president of some big company.
I just saw her going towards the dining car.
Come on, take her in custody.
Wait, there she is.
Nice and quiet. She couldn't get it. Hello? Are you Miss Myrtle Clark?
Yes, ma'am.
Jenny? Grab her!
I got her!
Please, this isn't necessary.
Oh, it isn't, huh? What's the big idea of pasting up all them stickers on the train?
Oh, I'm so ashamed of myself.
Well, you should be. You nearly caused a panic among the passengers. The time is at hand.
We were worried about Brad.
Oh, my. Well, that's awful.
Well, why do you do it?
Well, you see, I feel so strongly about the spiritual aspects of our lives. I get the urge to save people. Sometimes it's overwhelming.
Hmm. Well, how do you feel now?
I'm perfectly normal now, I assure you.
Well, we've got this here telegram from your nephew that says you escaped from an asylum.
A sanitarium. For some rest. And I know it was wrong of me. But you see, there was a convention in New York for the pharmaceutical people. That's my line. Glaxo fruit tablets. They keep you moving.
They sure do.
I am the president. And let me pay for what I have done.
Well, ma'am, we don't want your money. But I am very sorry to have this problem.
Oh, thank you. But you can trust me now. It's over. Here's all my stickers.
Well, why don't you go back to your room now? We'll see that you're made comfortable.
Oh, thank you both so much. You're so kind. I only wish I could feed you with loaves and fishes. Conductor.
Take out your pencil, Ida. I want to draw up a contract between Oscar Jaffe and Lily Garland. And incidentally, I want you to know that I only brought you back on account of your aging mother.
She's dead.
Your father, then. It's not necessary that the innocent should suffer.
Oh, gee, thanks, Oscar.
But draw up the contract in legal form. We'll offer a car to take her to and from the theater, catering on matinee days.
At the risk of losing my job again, I have to tell you, I think this is getting us nowhere. What we need is a play. She needs something she can read.
Well, I'll find a play.
Where? You of all people know you can't pull a play out of a hat. Not a good one.
I was born under the sign of Sagittarius. That's the archer. It means I find things. Just drop the contract on you.
Men.
Excuse me, please. Maestro. Maestro, it's you! It's you! I recognize you from the pictures!
Run along, we're busy!
You are genius! You are greatest theater man in world! I can kneel at your feet!
Let him stay, Ida. I turn away no one. What is it you wish, my son?
Maestro, this is grand honor! My friends in back of train, they'll be so jealous! But maybe you've seen her sometime, yeah? Under stage?
Oh, not acting.
Yeah, actors. We are belonging to the Passion Play in Germany.
Oh, my goodness, yes. The Ober-Ammergau Players. I should have recognized you. They're an institution, Ida. The purest form of theater in the world. Why, they've been putting on the Passion Play every year for centuries.
Yeah.
Glad to meet you.
The only true artists we have left. Not like our cheap Broadway hams. These people are consecrated to their art from infancy. Oh, it's the greatest form of theater in the world. Yeah. For hundreds of years, they've made the name of Ober-Ammergau famous. Why, it must have started back in...
1633!
And what part do you play?
I am the Christus.
Oh, sir, I am honored. Wait.
What?
Quiet.
Oscar.
Shh. I've got it.
What?
Sit down, please. Please, sit down. Oh, it's an inspiration. In the 11th hour, with my back against the wall.
What are you talking about?
The Passion Play. The greatest piece of theater in the world, with Lily Garland as the Magdalene. It's perfect at last. Something worthy of me. Oh, sign him up. Oh, wait. Is the rest of the troupe on board?
Yeah. We got all 10.
Sign them up immediately.
Oscar, can I speak to you alone for a minute?
Not now.
I'll call you a moment.
Hey, Ida, stop that. What are you doing? Are you crazy?
Oh, let's not talk about who's crazy here.
Ida, what are you doing?
Oscar?
Ida, this man is an artist. Apologize this instant.
You may not believe this, Oscar, but I am not just your business manager. I am your best friend, and I am not going to let you sign anybody up like this. You will lose money. You will lose everything!
There, old girl. She gets emotional.
Oscar, I will not let you get involved in any more phony art!
Ida, you don't know what's been happening to the theater public these past few years. Well, I will tell you. I have had my ear to the ground like an Indian. They are tired of the same old thing. Humdrum pedestrian lives played out in boring little rooms. Either it's constipated English people sipping gin and tonics through their elbowites, or a bunch of stinking farmers complaining to each other about their diet crops, or a bunch of alcoholic Irish people picking fights and being adorable. Well, I am going to give them something colossal, something new and magnificent, something that will make history, something that has never been done in this country before. I can see it now with in lights over Times Square, over Ammergau on Broadway.
I was in my room studying the Bible, but the print was too small in that light, so I thought I'd see if you had a magazine.
Yes, we have a magazine right here. Why don't you go back to your room and read it? If see that you're made comfortable.
If you don't mind, I will sit right here.
Well, all right, but if you start feeling funny, just call me.
Thank you. I will.
Broke. How can you demean yourself and even talk to the man?
The man is a big producer. This was a chance in a million. Look who's coming.
Oh, no.
Say, has Mr. Jaffe read my play yet?
Well, you know, I think he might now that you mentioned it.
Yeah. What did he say? Does he like it? What does he think?
Well, he hasn't told me all that just yet, but... I do know he's always wanted to produce two plays in a row about Joan of Arc.
Oh, I feel so close. Listen, do me a favor, okay? Now, I know this is a bit unorthodox, but you tell Mr. Jaffe that if he produces this play on Broadway, I'll throw in free surgery for the whole cast. I mean, I'm talking prostates, gallbladders.
Okay. That might just make all the difference, Doc.
Oh, I need it. I feel so inspired. Come on.
gonna go back tonight. I'm gonna write a whole new play right now about theater people like Mr. O'Malley and Mr. Jaffe. Big-hearted, generous troopers who are gonna give guys like me a chance.
And what happens after the dream sequence?
Ah. Oh, for God's
to get violent. He never hit a wounded man. How do I look?
Wounded.
Perfect. Mind the fort. I've got to go break a human heart.
George, I've always wanted a real house with a roof, a garden, a cookie jar. Oh, it's you?
Jackie!
Hello, Lily. I heard that you were on board, so I thought I would stop by to say hello.
I have nothing to say to you, Oscar. Please leave.
May I at least meet your friend? My, how young he looks. Are you adopting him?
George, this is Oscar Jaffe, worm extraordinaire.
Oh, snicker all you'd like. She'll be calling you names in no time.
I'm warning you, Jaffe. Don't bother Miss Garland, and I mean it.
George, no violence.
I want him to get out.
Be careful now. This arm, it's broken.
Good, I'll break the other one.
Ooh, I can see why you like him. He's rather prehistoric. Like one of those huge green dinosaurs with the very small heads.
Take that back!
Stop it, both of you! This would really finish me a public fight. You'd like nothing better than seeing our names flashing on the front pages.
Oh. Let him throw me out, Lily. It would be the final irony. I welcome it.
Good, then get out. You've got no rights in here.
No rights? He doesn't know about us.
Shut up, Oscar! Shut up!
No, no, I must explain myself to this young man. You see, Lily and I were lovers once. I must confess it was one of the great romances of all time. Oh, you should have seen her in bed, George.
Oh my God!
She was inventive, athletic.
I want to hear it.
As if she were trained in a circus.
Shut up! You could never stand to see anything decent and sweet of my life. You had to come here and blab!
Blab? Is that what you call it? I am proud of every hour we spend together.
So you're lying to me, right to my face, with every breath.
Don't start hammering, hammering, and hammering. I can't stand it.
Comfort her, sir. It is your privilege.
Yes, I did lie. Only to save you. Only to save you.
That was from Sappho.
Get out!
Lily! How could you?
Darling, I hate him. I despise him. He's the dirt under my feet. George, look at me. Look at me!
What an exit. Not a word. That's the exit we should have had at the end of the second act in Gypsy Heart.
Go crawl under your stone wherever you came from. There's nothing left for me to do but kill myself. Nothing left at all!
Oh, now I wouldn't do that quite yet if I were you, because I have a wonderful surprise for you. Now, you wait right here. Owen! Owen, I just played a scene that Puccini might have written for La Boheme. Now, where's Ida with that contract?
I don't know where she is, Oscar.
I need that contract.
I don't know where she is.
Lily is in just the right mood, and it's time to strike. We've got to find it. Hurry.
Are you still in love with him?
I hate him. I hate you. I despise all men.
Were you really lovers?
Of course we were, you idiot. I started in this production. We shared a house together. What do you think we did at night? Play Mahjong?
Then why did you lie to me, swearing on your love and honor? What a fake you are.
I'm a fake, me? You've been catting around Hollywood since the day you arrived. But you're a man, and I'm a woman. So I'm supposed to be pure and chaste. Well, let me tell you something. I never told you the truth in my life. I lied about all of them.
There was no midget.
There was two midgets. And the acrobat, he had a horse.
Oh my God. You wanted me to respect you?
Who needs your respect? I'm too big for respect. And the men I have known have understood that.
Men you've known? Men like Jaffe, you mean?
That's right. He'll tell you what I am. First class passenger. Entitled to privileges.
Oh, you're an artist.
You're damn right I am.
You're no woman. You're like some pet monkey full of tricks and vanities.
Oh, shut up. You bore me to death, George.
You know, I came here to forgive you, to give you another chance. But I'll see you damned before I ever speak to you again.
I have two words for you. I hate you. I despise you. Get out of my life. I throw you away. Get out! Oh my God, I can't stand myself.
When I find Ida, I am going to strangle her. I need that contract.
Well, I don't know where else to look, Oscar. I mean, she's going to be hiding in some other compartments.
Well, look again. Start at the engine and work your way back. And have you found the Bible yet?
Oh, not yet.
Well, look for that too now. Go, hurry.
Yes, sir.
Makes you feel better, please.
You're the most horrible excuse for a human being that ever walked on two legs.
Is this about your friend George? Because if he had been a real man, he would have taken you in his arms. It was a chance to show his love, and what did he do?
walked out with the clenched look of a Puritan with diarrhea.
Oscar, your philosophy about love doesn't interest me at all.
I am an Oriental, Lily. My love for you has blinded me. That has always been the trouble between us as producer and artist.
Oh, is that what it was it? What about your name in electric lights, bigger than everyone else's? Your grand delusions of being Shakespeare, Cardinal Richelieu, the Lama of Tibet, all rolled into one.
You're right.
I am?
I admit it. We do get wiser as we get older. I never really appreciated your greatness until I lost you. That last argument we had about percentages, how small and cheap I was.
Remember the quote you gave the papers when I threatened to leave you? Oh, Miss Garland is progressing nicely. Of course, I taught her everything she knows. It was like training an old cocker spaniel who thinks very slow.
How despicable I was!
I knew it!
And I knew you knew it. Oh, I can't believe I ever let you get away.
We let each other get away.
We had so much going for us. Looks, fame, money. Maybe that was the problem. Maybe we would have been better together if we lived on a farm somewhere and grown potatoes.
Yeah, I could have worn a polka dotted dress and slapped the hogs.
Slopped the hogs.
I could have scrubbed the South 40 and milked the steers.
You never were much of a country girl, were you?
No, but maybe we should have tried. We wouldn't have argued as much.
Oh, we never really argued.
You don't remember when I played Hedda Gabler? I took the axe off the wall and I tried to attack you in the wings, and then I chased you down 45th Street.
Or the time I broke your finger.
That was an accident. You were putting up the picture I was holding and the hammer slipped.
No, it didn't. It was deliberate. I was angry at you for the night before.
What happened the night before?
We were at the Roosevelt party. You wouldn't dance with me.
Oh, because you slept with that woman when you thought I wasn't looking? Who was her name? Oh, Teddy's cousin, Eleanor.
I wonder what ever happened to her.
Oh, Oscar, we don't know anything about love, do we? Unless it's written or rehearsed. We're only real between the curtains.
Oh, I could cut my throat for losing you.
And if you did, grease paint would run right through it.
And I've paid for it 1,000 times over. When I saw that movie of yours, Lily, oh.
Did you love it?
I wanted to vomit. All of your talent wasted, Lily.
You'd be interested to know it was a great success. The critics said I was marvelous, superb. Here, look if you don't believe me.
What's this?
Academy Award. But they're gonna call it the Oscar.
Oh, heaven forbid.
No, read it.
The Motion Picture Academy of Arts and Sciences Best Actress. Oh, Lily, don't fall for this. It's pathetic. You deserve better than this. The direction in that movie was despicable, and the lighting. Don't you remember, whenever you came on stage, I brought up the lights. You became radiant. People left the theater feeling spiritual.
Oscar, if all this adagio is preliminary to a contract offer, save your breath.
Who said anything about a contract? Shame on you, Lily.
You'd like nothing more than getting the name, my name on the contract, and I don't blame you. I do sell lots of tickets.
That statue must have done this to you. I didn't come here with any contract. I am not Max Jacobs. I came here with a dream. A dream we both had long ago. The part we planned as the climax to your career, the last golden stare, the great courtesan role.
Oh, so that's the big surprise you have for me. Another role where I sacrifice my broken body for the villain of my brother's life?
You didn't do so badly with Anna Christie, or Roxanne, or Cleopatra, and now I am talking about the greatest woman of all time. Just the memory of her has kept the world weeping for centuries. The Magdalene. Mary Magdalene, the wanton prostitute saved by Jesus Christ himself. The fallen woman that he pulls from a life of filth, who then must witness his heartbreaking crucifixion at the hands of their enemies.
Who wrote it?
God wrote it.
Who wrote the play?
No one knows. It's been performed for centuries in the little town of Oberammergau. You see, I am going to put on the Passion Play in New York. I've had it up my sleeve for years, just waiting for the right moment. The wickedest woman of her age. Sensual, heartless, beautiful, corrupting everything she touches, running the gamut from gutter to glory. Can you see her, Lily? Can you see this little wanton in tears at the foot of the cross? Wait, I have an idea. I will have Judas strangle himself with her hair.
No. Why not have Judas drink the poison that was intended for Mary?
It's an inspiration.
Right, and then as he's dying in agony, she stands over him. Die! Die! Die, thou wicked creature!
I can see it. You've got it, Lily. You've got it. I can see it all. I can see it all now. The Magdalene is a rich, aristocratic woman, her face framed in silk. And then her heart is broken by someone she loves, and she goes down, down, down into the depths. Oh, I'm going to make it my greatest production ever. I've got a whole troupe of actors from Europe. I flew over to Nuremberg just to find them. Oh, I've run the figures, Lily. And if the play runs for 5 years, I won't make a cent. You can have all the money. I just want to stagger New York. I want a desert scene with real camels and sand from the Holy Land. I'll throw a banquet for you in the second act for your lover, Pontius Pilate, governor of Judea. Yes, you'll be surrounded by your slaves and covered from head to toe in emeralds without a stitch of clothing on underneath.
Pontius, why do you stare at me? Have you not seen my gems before?
Your skin is like porcelain, almost translucent in its fineness. Think Michelangelo, the Pietà. Pilate begs you to marry him, and you laugh in his face, ha! Despising all men for what they've done to you. Your cruel laughter rings out through the palace, and it makes his blood run cold. My blood, it's cold. But that's nothing. That's nothing compared to the end, where you're standing in rags in the anteroom, and the Emperor Nero himself offers you half of his empire. And you answer him with a speech that may be the greatest piece of literature ever put on stage. You're showered in sunlight, transfigured with love and sacrifice. Never, you cry, never will I betray the love and trust of he who loves and trusts us all. Nero cringes, and you push him away, ha! And then the last we see of you, as the curtain falls, is a pathetic little figure in the marketplace selling olives. 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 3 for a drachma. Olives. What is it?
Oscar, you're a pure case of leaping insanity. You must have been drunk on your head as a kid.
Really?
Coming in here with real camels and seeing from the Holy Land? You're a scream. You're putting on the Passion Play? You haven't got $100 to your name.
I can raise every penny.
And I know just how you intend to do it. Get my name on a contract, go out and peddle it. Well, forget it. I'm done being your mail ticket.
You can call up any one of my banks in the morning.
Your banks? The ones that are taking your theaters away from you?
That's a lie. You have been talking to my enemies.
I've been talking to Miss Ida Webb, your loyal business manager. She came in here with some sob story about you committing suicide. Unless I took pity on you.
She didn't. She wouldn't.
She told me everything. She says you haven't got a dime. You're broke! You're busted!
It's revenge. I fired her for stealing.
Oh, shut up.
She had a secret Swiss bank account under the name Eric von Stroheim.
I'm so sick of you. lies!
I am offering you a chance to become immortal!
I want to stay mortal with a real producer!
Who?
He sent me the contract this morning.
Who is it?
Max Jacobs. Does that ring a bell?
Max Jacobs?
Read the papers in the morning.
You can't sign with him. He's a cheat. He's a sex maniac. I caught him in the men's room with my secretary and a small dog.
Oh, Oscar!
The man is illiterate. He can hardly sign his own name.
Oh, he signs them right on checks. Great big checks.
Oh, it's the money. Just another greedy ham. If I had a couple of bucks and I waved it in front of you, your mouth would start to water, and then you drool and start screaming, gimme, gimme, gimme.
That's right! Now get off before I have a porter throw you off the train!
Oh, look out who gets thrown off this train, traveling with a gigolo!
You fake! You swindler!
Stop it, you cheap little shop girl!
Get out! Oh, get out!
I'll tell you who's a fake you are!
Liar!
I made you!
Liar!
I gave you everything!
Liar!
Your rock, your tuck, even your name! Lily Garland, I gave you that! As there is a heaven, you will end up where you belong, in a burlesque house, Miss Mildred Plotka!
Ah!
Where is Ida? Where is the traitor whip? I will strangle her with my bare hands!
Oscar!
How, oh, you traitor, miserable Matahari!
Oscar, listen to me! You will never guess who I have outside with me. Myrtle Clark. She's the president of the Clark Rain Pharmaceutical Company, the biggest pharmaceutical venture in the country, and I talked her into financing your passion play from the religious standpoint. You can write her on your own ticket.
Oh,
she's worth millions.
Where is she?
Outside. Would you like to meet her?
Yes, bring her in immediately.
Miss Clark, come in. This is Mr. Jack.
How do you do, ma'am?
Miss Webb has told me all about you. I find it quite unusual, though, that a man of your profession is so interested in religion.
Mm-hmm.
What is your denomination, Mr. Jaffe?
Denomination? Yes, of course. My denomination.
Yeah.
I am happy to say that I am a Baptist.
Alleluia!
Alleluia! The moment the train comes to a stop. The passion play is in production.
I'll file them in, please. Will that be all, sir?
No, my good woman, I have not yet hardly even begun.
Well, then I'll have to get some more blanks.
Well, please do, and please hurry. It is a matter of life and death. Oh, and how much money did I tell Miss Clark that we needed to start with?
300,000 potatoes.
I should have told her 350,000. Oh, go get her, Owen. She took me by surprise. It was the artist in me that answered, not the businessman.
Oscar, I wouldn't bear down on her so soon, you know. I mean, look, that's a big bag of money.
Is it?
Boy.
It seems like mere confetti to me that I spread before myself like dust on the wind.
Oh, Oscar.
Oh, perhaps you're right. Miss Clark did strike me as somewhat of a dreamer.
Oh, yeah. Well, she's got me baffled, you know. She just twitters away like some dithering saint.
I've always attracted that sort of person. They're drawn to something spiritual in me. Oh, wait, I forgot to tell Lily about the money.
Oh, yeah.
Lily, I've got good news. No, not good. I have got spectacular news.
How dare you come in here again, Oscar?
Oh, stop it. So we had a few words. So what? I accept your apology.
My apology?
Listen, Lily, the passion play now has a backer.
Ina Thonder. She's the president of Clark Rady Pharmaceuticals, and she's worth a fortune.
Oscar!
No, it's true. She's some sort of religious fanatic, knows the Bible forwards and backwards, and she's writing us a check just to get us started.
Oscar, is this true?
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. I swear on my mother's grave.
Your mother's not even dead.
That's not the point. You can meet her, Miss Clark. You could ask her yourself. You can ask her anything.
Why does this sound like a very fishy to me, like an Oscar Jaffe special?
Oh, for pity's sake, woman, do you want to be in the play or not?
Of course I do. From what you said, it could be the best production we've ever done together.
Well,
you know I'd walk through fire to be in another truly great production with you.
But what?
Best times of my life were in the theater next to you, doing something that truly matters. But when I think of how many times you made promises you never kept, you never intended to keep.
How can you say that? I intended to keep every one of them. And I bent over backwards to make them happen just for you. Medea, your finest hour. Desdemona, you were a goddess. Sacagawea was a mistake, I'll admit. But this, Lily, this is a dead certainty. Now, are you with me or not? Yes or no?
Yes. Yes, I'm with you.
Heart and soul?
Heart and soul.
Now, go fix yourself up. You look hideous. Fix your face. Put on a decent dress. I want to introduce the great Lily Garland to Myrtle Clark. Be alluring, difficult, winsome, impossible. In other words, be yourself.
I've got those blanks now, sir.
Excellent. Then we will resume. The next wire goes to John Ringling of Ringling Brothers Circus. Owen, you'll have to find the address immediately. Dear John, I am in the market for 25 camels, 4 elephants, and an ibis. It's the royal bird of Egypt. Wire me your rock bottom price, Oscar Jaffe. Now, he's going to be a bit miffed, but I'm going to wire the Berlin Zoo for the lions. They have the better specimens. We're going to need 10 or 12. Make a note, Owen. Where are you going to house all these monsters?
Oh, we'll
build a zoo out beyond the green room. We're going to redo the whole theater and make it resemble a grotto. Owen, do you remember the name of the Sultan of Turkey?
Oh, not offhand. Who's going to play?
Oh, no, I don't want him. I want his dervishes, the whirling ones. We'll need a dozen. Remind me to take it up with the Arabian and Turkish consuls. How many sheep did I say to order?
20 sheep.
Oh, no, you're going to have to change that to read 50. No, we mustn't stint. We must have a complete flock. Now, the next wire goes to Richard Strauss.
Richard Strauss. Do you mean Richard Strauss the composer?
No, Richard Strauss the plumber. Of course the composer. Greatest of the century. He happens to be in New York right now, so we're in luck. Dear Richard, I need you to write score for Passion Play, the one with Christ in it. Wanted to sound like Salome, but not so much French horn this time. Meet me for lunch on Thursday at the Palm Court. Oscar Jaffe.
The woolly sheep is at the gate.
Oh. Stop the tomfoolery, Owen, and let him in. Conductor, that'll be all for now, but hold yourself in readiness.
Yes, sir.
Maestro, we have found first part of manuscript. Second part is missing yet, but I can tell you what happens. The Christos dies. Then he floats up to heaven mit der singing angels. In Germany, we use ropes and pulleys.
Well, leave me what you got and keep looking. Oh, it's in German, I see.
Yeah. But I can translate. I speak the English linguisticals as good as the German. Maestro, you will have
Supper mit us? Yeah? We got Knutwurst.
Well, just run along and I'll call for you soon.
Wiedersehen. Oh, they are going to be such sensations in New York. They are pure artists.
John Rain, witch incarnate, I condemn thee and thy doctor to the flames of hellfire!
Who is that?
I have absolutely no idea.
Owen, run over and get Lily and bring her in.
We'll be right back. Right.
Miss Clark is coming with a Bible and a big fat check.
Perfect.
Hey, Lily, are you ready yet?
Would you give me a minute, you real good son, so you could shut it?
Well, she purred like a pussycat, and she'd be right in.
Come in, dear lady, please. Have a seat.
Thank you.
Miss Webb tells me that you have a Bible that you can loan me. The Bible. There's no one writing dialogue like this anymore. Of the tree of knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not eat, for on the day that thou should eat of it, thou shalt die. No wonder they called it God.
Well, Lily will be in just a jiffy.
Who is Lily?
Lily Garland, an actress who I'm considering for one of the parts.
Is she a professional actress?
Of course.
Oh, I don't know about that. I wouldn't want the passion play contaminated by any woman like that.
Oh, nor would I, Miss Clark. The religious flavor must come through in a bath of glory. But I don't have to remind you what sort of woman the Magdalene was.
Oh, is the Magdalene going to be in the play? She's not my favorite character.
Nor mine, of course. But when you meet Miss Garland, you will realize at once that the part of the Magdalene might have been written for her. It is an opportunity we could not pass up lightly.
Oh, there she blows!
Welcome,
dear lovely Lily.
Excuse me, I'm afraid you caught me quite unawares. I haven't had a moment to change.
No matter, Lily. You turned this wretched little room into a palace. Allow me. Miss Lily Garland. Miss Myrtle Clark.
It's a pleasure to meet you, ma'am.
Please sit down, my child.
Just for a moment, thank you.
I guess you know who this is, Lily. Myrtle Clark, president of the Clark Rainey Pharmaceutical Company, the biggest pill manufacturer in the world.
Shall I ring up for some ginger ale, my dear? None of us drink anything in the way of liquor. It's against the rules of my organization.
No, thank you, darling.
You don't look at all as I expected.
Nor do you. I expected some hard-born old businesswoman. And you? You have the look of an artist about you. A creative light of passion shining from your eyes. I'm overwhelmed.
Thank you.
And I hear you'll be joining us in that humble yet valiant little effort we call the theater.
Well, all I'm really doing is investing some money. I brought along the check.
Show it to her, Oscar. $300,000.
Good Lord!
Is the topic of the play. That's right, Lily.
And of course it is. What a man! He's my favorite character in all of fiction.
There you go, Lily. You can count the zeros.
What a beautiful gesture, Miss Clark. Thank you.
Well, as I was saying, it's only a starter.
You know, if someone would have told me an hour ago, I'd be sitting here like this, discussing art and culture with a woman with your vision, I would have peed myself.
Perhaps you'd like to look this over, Lily. It's a contract I had drawn up for you to sign. It covers the terms of our agreement.
We'd really like you to have us, Miss Garland, with us.
Thank you, Miss Clark.
Now, if I could just see the agreement.
Once Miss Garland has signed it, you may read it.
Now, Mr. Jaffe, I'm very good at contracts.
Now, this is not a business transaction, Miss Clark. This is an obeisance to a lovely woman and a fantastic artist.
Thank you, Oscar. It's like old times, isn't it?
Perhaps you'd like to sign it.
I prefer to read it first, if you don't mind. It's been a delight to have met you, Miss Clark. Truly a delight.
I hope I haven't been too boring.
Oh, no, no. Not at all. Very fascinating. I look forward to our association together. But above all, I look forward to working on a theatrical drama set in the Holy Land, the land of the spirits, the land of my youth. I grew up there, you see. I used to play in the sea of the land of the Danube. I used to ride camels sitting high on their divine humps, eating figs and dromedaries. And did you know? Even as a child, when I used to touch the land, I could see the anguish in Christ as he looked down bleeding from his cross and said to the Pharaoh, "Let my people go!"
Goodbye, my dear. Goodbye.
You have made me very happy.
And you, I.
She's a very holy woman. A little confused, but holy.
I think you made quite an impression on her.
Oh, dear. I tried so hard not to look below her neck.
Oh, for pity's sake, Ida. Have them put a sign on the door not to be disturbed. Oh, it's you. Come in, sir.
I am finding second part of manuscript. It was an utter suitcase meant towels from last hotel.
Thank you. Miss Clark, may I introduce you to an extraordinary man and a fantastic artist? I have hired him and his colleagues to play in our production.
How do you do it? What part is he going to play?
Der Christus!
He has played it for 20 years, and his father before him, and his father before that.
And two uncles before them, and one cousin who had stutter and was not so good.
Well, this is quite a surprise, and an unpleasant one at that. I have nothing more to say. Goodbye.
Oh, Miss Clark, wait. What's the problem?
Well, as I was saying, Miss Webb, if I was going to finance the Passion Play, it would be with one proviso, that I would play the part of Christ.
What?
Oh, that's yes. Crazy. I've been playing it for 20 years.
Stop. Ida, show him the door.
For 300 years, Mr. Chaffee.
I will call you soon. Now out. I don't want to see anyone else without an appointment. All right. Miss Clark, you want to play Christ? You've got it. You're Christ.
I am.
Absolutely. We start rehearsals in 6 weeks. Get the address from Ms. Webb.
Oh, Mr. Jack, you will not be disappointed. I know every single word of the text, and not only my favorite passages, either.
Wonderful. Well, this has been quite pleasant. Thank you. Goodbye.
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 You're not really gonna let her play Jesus Christ, are you?
The King of Kings? Don't be insane. I wouldn't let her play King Kong. But I don't trust her. She could change her mind at any second. So here's what I want you to do. I want you to jump off the train when we get to Toledo and cash this check. It's drawn on the Toledo Bank.
At the National Trust. I know the director there.
Ah, splendid. I will endorse it.
I hate to crow, Oscar, but I want it to be known. United Way, you're a pinch.
You know, I have been thinking of promoting you. Remind me when we get to New York to hire a secretary for you to boss around all by yourself. Now here, put this in your purse. Now where is that Bible? Ah, and my pencil? Ah, here. I've got some editing to do.
It's outrageous. That's what it is, outrageous.
It's not the conductor's fault, honey.
Now, tell me exactly what happened.
Well, we were in the upper berth.
Yeah, we were taking a nap, that's all.
And the curtain was pulled aside without notice. And this horrible little crazy woman comes running in with a sticker and pastes it on the window.
Conductor, conductor! She's on the loose! She's at it again!
I just heard.
She's up and down those aisles with those stickers like a phantom.
Are we in danger?
Not in the least, madame. The authorities will be picking her up in Toledo and will be there in 10 minutes. Now, porter, please escort this nice lady and fine gentleman to their compartment and make sure that they're comfortable.
Well, thank you very much. It's very kind of you. Come along here.
Our lives are in danger with that creature running loose.
I can assure you she's harmless. Just a little crazy is all.
Conductor, what time do we get to Toledo?
Well, we'll be there in 7 minutes. Now, she hasn't been giving Mr. Jaffe any trouble, has she? The lady indeed.
Not in the least, not on Miss Clark.
Well, then you don't happen to know where she's hiding, do you?
Hiding? You mean hiding? From what?
Well, we've been trying to keep it under wraps so as not to alert the passengers, but it's a pretty sad case all around.
Almighty woman. What are you talking about?
Well, Miss Myrtle Clark is the one that's been pasting up them stickers.
That's a lie. She's an executive.
Was an executive. We caught her red-handed. Took a whole satchel of stickers away from her. This here telegram from her nephew says she escaped from an asylum. The authorities are picking her up in Toledo and will be there in 5 minutes. Apparently, she's some sort of religious nun. Poor lady. Well, thanks. Oh, and please tell Mr. Jaffe I got those wires off.
Can't you see the man's in love with you? He's been pining over you for 4 years. Now come on and just sign it while the sap is flowing.
All right, I'll sign it.
Lily, stop! I want you to get out of here!
What do you want?
I just need to talk to you for a minute before you sign that contract.
George, get out.
Lily, please, I've never meant anything to you.
All right, George, this better be good. Owen, keep it warm for me. I'll be right back.
Toledo, now arriving. Toledo, Ohio, watch your step.
Owen, Owen, did you sign it yet?
Oh, not yet.
Oh, Owen, you've been fooled. That woman's a flark. No lunatic, she escaped from an asylum.
What woman is that?
A backer. The detectives are coming on now to take her off the train.
Have you told Oscar yet?
No, not yet.
Why, it was you. Why would you jump off the train?
Signed commitments yet? Oh, what if he signed with Ringling? Oh, with Strauss? Oh. He could go to jail.
Oh. Do me a favor and just kill yourself, because I don't want to see what he does to you.
This is awful. Owen, come on.
How dare you talk to me as though I'm your wife or something? God forbid.
Lily.
He doesn't want me seeing Jaffy. Well, guess what? I'm signing the contract, so help me God, you forced me into it. Owen, where's Owen? Oh my God, he's got the contract. Thanks a lot, you idiot. Owen, Owen, Owen.
You're making a mistake.
Excuse me. I'll check the bedroom.
Good idea.
There's nobody in there.
What the heck is this?
This is Detective Barnes from the Toledo Police Department.
Yeah, we're looking for a passenger named Clark. He escaped from some insane asylum somewhere. We're here to collect him.
What's he look like?
You know, he's one of those religious types. He's always carrying a Bible, and he's always reading from it. Come on, let's go.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto Joseph in a dream and said, "Do not fear to take Mary as your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit."
I got it! I got him! I got him!
Oh my God! Oh my God!
It's news to me. I have been bamboozled.
You liar!
No, this is the first I'm hearing it. You have to believe me.
You deceitful wretch!
No, I knew nothing about it.
How dare you make a fool out of me?
Ida told me that she was rich, and I believe her. She showed me her car.
Liar! You're a liar! You're a liar!
The room is spinning around. Oh, water. Owen, Ida, get me water.
Look who's fainting, you fake, you lunatic. Oh my God, I can't stand it. Open the windows. Oh my God, I'm having a breakdown. Oh my God.
Hello, Lily. That's the prettiest girl on 10 continents.
Max Jacobs.
Maxie, my love, my darling, my sweetheart.
It's good to see you, kid. Now listen, I got a new Somerset Maugham play, and it fits you perfect.
What?
So what do you say, we got a deal?
You bet we don't.
No!
feeling about this in New York. It came to me all of a sudden like a bolt of cloth from the blue. Max Jacobs, I says to myself, the girl's in trouble. And you better act now or you're gonna lose her to that rat-faced, thumb-sucking, pompous jackass, Oscar Jaffe. And that's when I was feeling kindly things. So I took a plane to Toledo, one of those small Pied Piper jobs, and I get on this stinking train and I see your bacon. And you call yourself an agent? You're good for nothing. You got no brains. You got nothing between those eyes. Because if you did, you would have saw this coming straight at you like the three musketeers of the apocalypse. And let me tell you something. If Jackie gets her in another show, you'll lose her for good. Oh, here she comes.
The last light of the waning moon gutters through the shimmering curtains. Emily struggles to sit up, holding on to an old rocking horse that gave her so much joy as a child. She looks around, and there is Jimmy, sitting next to her. His eyes are swollen with tears and opium. Oh, Jimmy, what is there to life that I have not had too much of? Throw all those silly medicines out the window. I'd like the room to look a bit more like it used to. Like the nurse child, leaves the plane. Jimmy takes me in his arms, he gazes into my eyes, and he says, blah, 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 blah. Darling, I don't need more flowers, or more sunshine, or more laughter. You're all the springtime I'll ever need. Then Jimmy starts to cry, sobbing into the blanket, blah, 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 blah. Oh, Jimmy, poor Jimmy. Please don't cry, Jimmy. Open the window, just a little. Oh, is it raining? Soft, warm rain on a sad, broken heart. Jimmy, how did that little play go? Wow! Perfect death! So simple! Asking that heartbreaking little question about the poem.
Just think how great you'll be once you sink your choppers into it.
I haven't been so moved in years. George, now there's a lover for you. He knows, he feels, he understands.
I understand.
You understand, Buckus. So what's the verdict? Do we go into the rehearsals?
Maxie, this play was written for me. It's my life. It has grief, joy, tuberculosis. But the second curtain act has to change. It should be I, not Jimmy, that makes the speech about his mother and children.
No problem. Someone's going to fix it up. So listen, darling, tomorrow we leave the train, we go straight to the lawyer's office, and we drop the contracts. You get an advance payment, no nonsense.
Now, that's what I call facts.
Lily, how much is he paying you?
I'm paying her plenty. That's what I'm paying her.
George, I can take care of myself. Thank you.
But this is my job, all right? I'm hoping 5 a week.
We'll talk when I say we talk. Because she trusts me. We go back a long ways.
But that's not the point.
Did you have any trouble locating Mr. O'Malley and Miss Webb?
No, sir. They were together in the observation car. Sure. But they were a bit worse for wear, if you know what I mean.
Drinking.
I'm afraid so.
And did you tell them what I said?
I did. I told them it was a matter of life and death.
I'll call you if I need you.
The Black Watch, sire, with their bagpipes.
You're both drunk, I suppose.
Drunk? Sober? What difference does it make? The hearing?
It is typical of my career that in the greatest crisis of my life, I am surrounded by two incompetent alcoholics.
Listen here, Oscar. We are in absolutely no mood for a lot of your fuzzy lamentation.
That's all right, Owen. It'll only take a few minutes. Just need to say a few words.
No more words. I dirt and crawled on my face until I'm sick. What is that?
What did you hit me that?
I didn't mean for you to see that.
Oh, do something.
But what would you like me
to do? But I see that you have guessed why it is that I've called you here to say goodbye. Do you remember a time not long ago when I was Oscar Jaffe? My outer office was full of celebrities and cabinet ministers.
Is it ridiculous that I'm not listening to a word that I tell you until he puts that fouling piece away?
Well, I know that you'll be blue for a while, but it's better this way. Yesterday, I was Oscar Jaffe, the Wizard of Broadway. Tomorrow, a silly old fool haunting the lobbies of other managers' first nights. You wouldn't want to see me that way, would you, boys? You'll think of me whenever you hear that wild sound in the night.
This is absolutely ridiculous. You know what, Oscar? I'm leaving.
Goodbye, boys. Hello, pale messenger of death, cold passport to heaven, or to hell.
Hello? What? Please, I'm so ashamed of myself. I didn't mean to put the stickers up. Please,
hey, don't
shoot
it.
Let go of that.
Stop
it.
Let go of that.
Oh, my, who's that?
Shot me!
Where did she shoot you?
Over here by the sofa! Good Lord, I'm bleeding!
Oh, my goodness! I'll call the doctor! Wait.
He pointed the gun at me! It was his life or mine!
She took the gun away from me and shot me!
It was self-defense!
But just shut up and stay right there!
Oh, I can see my obituary now! Oscar Jaffe, killed by lunatic, also produced plays.
Oscar! Can I get you anything? Do you need a rabbi? Ooh, do you need a bris?
No prayers. I will argue my own case before God.
No, Oscar, don't you talk like that. You old wounded lion, you. They can't keep you down. You'll be up at the count of nine.
The doctor's coming. Harris, is he still breathing? But get away from him, you.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Don't leave me alone, boys.
Yes. Never, we're not going anywhere, Oscar. What's the matter here?
What happened?
I keep everybody else. Keep them all out.
Get out. Get out.
What? I'm out of here.
Who shot him?
Jaffe been shot.
Oscar. Oscar.
No. Stay here. Oscar. Wait. Stay.
Oh, just as I suspected. I've seen this before. There's lots of excitement, but no damage.
So it's not serious then?
The bullet barely grazed him.
Oof, what are you talking about?
What I'm saying is that you're fit as a fiddle and there's no damage at all.
But I feel weak. It must be internal injuries. What about all the blood?
That's often the case. Where were the grazing? There are blood vessels on the surface of the skin.
Oscar, this is the worst thing you've ever put me through.
Boy.
Wait.
What?
I have an idea.
Oh, Oscar.
No, it's an inspiration.
Oscar!
Doctor, I'd like to play a little joke on someone. Would you help me?
I don't know.
Now, I know that you have a fabulous sense of humor. I know from that magnificent manuscript you have for Joan of Arc, which I have practically decided to produce.
Darn. Okay, what do you want me to do?
Just stand back here and look at me and say nothing. Ida, where's the contract? The last one I brought up for Lily.
I have it.
Get it for me. She's going to sign it.
She's what?
Yes, she's going to sign it. She still loves me. I can tell from the screaming. I just have to be able to reach that love, bring her to her senses. Oh, boys, it'll be the last thing I ever ask you to do. Now, Owen, go and tell her that I'm dying. And don't overact.
Okay, Oscar. Ooh, it's a Jaffe production!
Now, conductor, could you move this chair to the middle of the room? perfect, perfect. Now the lights. Bring the lights down just a little. It's the last scene of Camino.
Thank Wagner, Lady Garland!
Keep back, no one comes in here!
It's his last request! Oh, shit! Thank Wagner, Lady Garland!
Oscar! Oscar!
We are here to
Oscar!
Who's
Lily, Oscar?
Oh,
yes, Lily.
Lily, Lily, where's your hand? Give me your hand.
Why did you do this? How could you do this?
Oh, Lily, it's better this way. They had all left me, those that I needed and loved. Oh, it's getting dark. Oh, stay with me. Stay with me just a little while longer. No
Oscar.
More tears. No more tears, Lily. No more tears. It's not your fault. I only wish that I could have seen you, held you just once more. Ida?
Yes.
Ida, where is the contract? The last contract I had drawn up for Lily Garland.
Right here.
Oh, it's so hard. It's so hard to die in this barren place. I should have waited until I was back home in the theater among the dust and echoes that I loved so well. Ida?
Yes.
The contract? Ask her if she would write her name on it. It will be my monument.
Here's a pen then.
I will. Oscar.
Oh, give it to me, hurry. Hurry, give it to me while I can still see. I wanna read her name on it.
Let me get out!
Max Jacobs! Lily, don't sign that contract!
You're too late, Max Jacobs!
You know, but bum!
Herring salesman!
Thief!
Liar!
Cheat!
Office boy!
Venus, my Cupid, my
Hermaphrodite.
Oh, hey, is the car ready yet?
What car?
To take Mr. Jaffe to the theater.
The theater, yes, absolutely. We go directly to the theater.
Hey, hey,
hello, boys.
Did you miss me, fellas?
Hey, Miss Garland, how'd you like Hollywood?
Well, you know what they say? It's a place where they shoot too many pictures, but not enough actors.
Now, boys, I've got an exclusive for you. We're producing a new play on Broadway this season by Somerset Maugham, with stage effects by John Ringling and music by Richard Strauss. But most importantly, it stars this country's greatest actress, Miss Lily Garland. Yes, that's right. We are back together again, like Beatrice and Benedict, like King Arthur and Queen Guinevere.
Like Caesar and Lucretia Borgia.
All right, scholars, thanks a lot.
See you at the opening, boys.
By the way, Oscar, Chanel is going to be designing all my new costumes.
No, no, no. We use Schiaparelli this year.
You know nothing about fashion, darling.
I merely created your entire look.
You don't even know Schiaparelli.
I invented Schiaparelli. Her name was Ethel Bobstein from Altoona, Pennsylvania.
Ooh, just like old times.
Yeah, ain't it wonderful?
To the theater?
To the theater.
Alleluia.
So very much. I know you've already met him, so I'm not going to introduce him for the first time. But what you don't know about our director is that he does everything. So he cleans the toilets, he makes the coffee, he built the set, he found us all. He's the flagpole that we sit on. He is our Oscar Jaffe, Mr. Patrick Vitale.
Created all the sound effects you heard.
She helped paint, she helped direct, she helped decorate the place. And I just want to tell you also that she also directs shows at St. Anthony's. So next spring, she's going to be directing The Sound of Music. So please, everybody go see Barbara Peters' direction in St. Anthony's. Let's see, who else am I going to have? Pat Ebner. Pat Ebner did the like soundboard. I did the She also did, helped us with the sets. She wore all the costumes, everybody's costumes were from Pat Ebner. Thank you, Pat, for all that. Joan Pandolfi, come on out, Joan. Joan Pandolfi. Hip surgery, so she had to bow out. And I want to thank Ellen Davidson, who jumped into her place. Joan helped us with the tickets. She helped us with the concession stand, and she's helped us a great deal. So thank you, Joan, for everything you've done. The set was built by Steve Ostrom, Bill Holfeld. Barbara Peters, Pat Ebner, and myself. We had a set consultant from Broadway. The guy's name is John Cameron, and he came here and he helped us design the set. So I want to thank John. He's not here this tonight, but I'd like to thank John Cameron. I want to thank Barbara Peters again, Pat Ebner, my wife Ramona, who helped paint the set and decorate it. They did a wonderful job. Michelle Hopkins did the poster design, so that was it. Mike Wagner did the tickets and the play bill. I want to thank Councilman Paul Valentine. Paul, where are you? You're in the back. Councilman Paul Valentine and Valentine Electric, because that's why we have the lights. And if one is out, he sends somebody over, and he's been very, very generous to us. I want to thank him. And also, Councilman Valentine is going for re-election this year. So in November, Michael Councilman Paul Valentine. Okay, what else? We want to thank Flora from Nora's Hairstylist, who's down the street. She did the beautiful hairstyles that we did. And she didn't do his, though. I want to thank Taylor O'Daniels for giving out the playbills and helping us with the confession stand. Suzanne is our marketing manager, and all those ads, pretty much all those ads that are in that playbill, she brought in. She brought over $850 worth of ads. I want to thank the Japan Reformed Church, especially Pastor Don Cooper, who appreciate very much. I want you to take home the playbills, because we worked hard on the playbills, and all these businesses donated money for us so that we can be here. So please use them, whoever's in the playbook. The only one I don't really want you to use is Moritz Funeral Home. I mean, if you have to, Gene is a nice man, so don't call him. But if you don't have to, that's fine. But use everybody else. I want to thank my family and my friends, especially my wife, Ramona, for all the help and support that they've given us and allow us to come here and play and do what we have to do. Finally, I want to thank my cast. One more time, give them a round of applause. You know, I said this every year, but this was pretty hard, you know, it was very hard to do the show because there was a lot of dialogue and this, and we had to make sure who's coming out of what door and this and that. But I want to thank them very, very much for all their help and support. I love you guys all of you. I'm very proud to be on the same stage with you. Okay, I know everybody's waiting for who's getting the $10. Turn on the lights, I want to see the lights, turn on the lights. I have two $10 bills. Two people are gonna get $10. You guys were wonderful, you guys were amazing. I wish we could give you all $10. So I'm gonna give you two $10 to two people. Thank you again for coming.
to us, and thank you so much for coming. And we'll see you next year!